My name is Marl. I'm the president of PurpleBug, the developer of MyDoctorFinder. So a couple of years ago, we started this project. And before that, going to be discussing to everyone some digital trends happening in the Philippines. So what's PurpleBug? We are a digital marketing agency. We're handling different companies in developing different applications and projects in digital media. Okay. So the world is changing. There are a lot of things that we used to do in the last 10 years ago that we don't do anymore. Like, and because of that, there are a lot of shifts and changes happening in communications. Samples of that is that a lot of postal companies around the world are either closing or being bankrupt. The reason behind that is nobody sending snail mails anymore because of the development of emails. Another classic example is that a lot of telecoms companies right now are losing revenue because the traditional way of communicating is no longer available because everyone is doing Skype. Remember back then, if you have families abroad, what you used to do is do an international call, or if you have families on different parts of the country, you do a long-distance call. Right now, you use Skype. You use Viber to communicate with your friends, you don't use text anymore. And you use PDF instead of using international fax. So there's a huge shift in habits on how people, even how people read news. As you can see, a lot of people are browsing information over the internet nowadays instead of reading newspapers. And instead of watching television on a regular time slot, everyone is watching it over YouTube. That's the reason why some broadcast companies right now are developing different platforms, how they can make the content available online. And a lot of artists right now are complaining on how music are being heard by a lot of people because nobody is downloading it anymore. So they're earning revenue during concerts and with the copyright of their music. So the world we used to know is shifting to this technology adoption, and Philippines is just and is adopting a lot of these changes. Okay, so here's some stats about the Philippines. So we have around 105 million Filipinos. So that's the estimated number of Filipinos because we still don't have the census yet. And about a third of it is internet users. Because the problem with the rest of the country, they don't have internet connection because they belong to the rural areas or far-flung areas. But a lot of the telecom companies right now, what they're doing is they're currently developing different ways how to get these people connected. That's the reason why everyone is using mobile internet connection. And there's about 34 million active Facebook users. So about a third of the population uses Facebook. And what's interesting about that fact is that when we started digital marketing about 4 years ago, a lot of the users are coming from ages 22 to 30 years old. Right now, there's an interesting increase in the population of people below 20 and people above 50. So it means that a lot of people who are younger are accessing the internet, and a lot of the people older are also accessing the internet. And another interesting fact, the mobile penetration in the Philippines is around 106 million. It means that there are more phone users than the people. So it means that a lot of us love our phone very much. So it only means that a lot of us even have multiple SIM cards to access different telecom stuff. So with regards to the project that we developed, the MyDoctorFinder, before we presented that, what we tried doing is researching whether there are currently a lot of searches being done by a lot of people with regards to keywords or topics in healthcare. And we found out that a lot of Filipinos are already accessing internet to get more information. So actually, I can have the next slide. So any idea of the most frequently typed keyword in the internet? So So if you see the slide that I clicked a while ago, that's where it is. So any idea? Sex. That's part of the one of those highest searches, but not in Yahoo. Any idea? Okay. So very appropriate to the discussion we had this morning. So there are about 4,670 people every month searches the word psychiatrist. Yes. So it's this is really very interesting because before this, I was thinking that a lot of people are just either searching doctors, hospitals, or clinics. So with this one, we found out that Filipinos are searching very specific topics already in the internet and very specific information of healthcare practitioners and healthcare professionals. So about 4,560 people access searching the word doctor, hospital, surgery, healthcare. So top 6 is dermatologist, so dental care, so 9 in plastic surgery, and even orthopedic specialist. So a lot of people have broken bones. So here's the top 20. So physicians, metropolitan hospital, primary health care, health services, mental hospitals. So number 1 is psychiatrist and number 15 is mental hospitals. So we've seen that a lot of people are accessing internet to seek information about this type of things. And drugs or prescription drugs, eye doctors and clinics. Okay. Everyone discussed about ASEAN integration and its effect to the Philippines and the effects to the country. This is a very interesting slide from United Nations Conference on Trade and Development. It says here that 5 among the top the best performing economies in the world would be coming from Southeast Asia. With ASEAN integration just around the corner, it means that these 5 strong industries, 5 strong countries will be performing well and will affect a lot of movement of people and businesses. So with that, a lot of with the movement of people and with movement of economy, it means that a lot of people will be going from country to country, and one thing that people will be needing will be healthcare practitioners, doctors, and hospitals. So here's some stats about Southeast Asia. So the total population is around 630 million. So primarily because of Indonesia, which is the biggest one, the Thailand, Vietnam, Philippines, and Malaysia. The internet users is around 195 million. The active Facebook users is 161, and the internet penetration is around 26%. The total internet users, this is mobile penetration. So this is 600 people. So it means the trend in Southeast Asia is also the same in the Philippines. There are more phone users than the actual population. So with that, what we did is, because of this information, we realized that a lot of people are searching information online, and we really need to help providing this information to a lot of people. That's the reason why we developed MyDoctorFinder. So it's really very simple. What we did is we tapped into different hospitals, clinics, and different healthcare providers to provide us a list of different information. So we started with the doctors. Currently, the system has 25,000 lists of doctors with different specialty across different countries. So you can either choose the specialty, the location, or their technician affiliation. And if you're very fortunate, if they provided their schedule, you can also even check the schedule that they have and some contact information. You can also check different hospital location, the different pharmacy, and different specialty clinics. Actually, the story behind this is that one of the employee, my employee, is asthmatic. So the problem is, whenever we travel, what we usually do is check which is the nearest hospital or the nearest clinic, just in case an emergency might happen. So since it's really very difficult to search those information online, I told my team, we're just going to develop something like this in order for us to provide an information that's going to be very, very useful to a lot of people. That's where the idea comes in. So here's a sample of the content. So once you dig in, you check the information of the doctor. So you can check the specialty, the hospital and affiliation, the HMO, and as mentioned, the schedule or the hospital schedule that they have. So the search result is going to be either on an alphabetical listing or based on the nearest doctor nearest you. Okay, so here's a listing of this is the sample listing of all of the clinics and the hospitals, so you can also check which is the nearest hospital. Just for example, you're traveling to Batangas, for example, during this period that you guys will be traveling, you travel to another province and you don't know the nearest hospital, and you're bringing a parent or a friend who might have a situation during the travel. So it's very handy to get this information before you travel to that location. So what's another interesting fact is that after we developed the online version of it, since Farouk also mentioned that mobile penetration in the Philippines is very, very high nowadays, what we did is we developed a mobile application. So who's using an iPhone right now? That's good because you can download the application. Yes, you can already download the application and you can get a list of the 25,000 doctors. So what's good with this is that we also even integrated this with Waze. What's good with that is that with a click of a button, you can even navigate towards the hospital or towards the location of the doctor. Okay, so you don't need to worry for the Android user. The version is going to be available eventually. Okay, so basically that's MyDoctorFinder. So for more information about this, you can send me an email at marl.gonzales@purplebug.net. Thank you guys.